Sri Sukhendu Sekhar Raj.
Sir, I rise to support this bill. However, the concerns expressed by Madam Yagnik and Vaishnoji, I associate with those concerns. We are talking about the Hong Kong Convention, International Convention for Safe and Environmentally Sound Recycling of Ships 2009, and we are observing the 10th anniversary of that convention. But sir, many NGOs, including the international famous NGO Greenpeace, they had criticized the objectives and recommendations of the Hong Kong Convention in view of the fact that it will impact our environment. Sir, coming to the bill, in the statement of objects and reasons, it is said that ship breaking code revised in 2013, which is existing in our country, does not provide penalties for contravention of the provisions of code. And for that reason, some penalties have been prescribed in this bill, in Chapter 9, Clause 31, Subclause 1 to 5, and Clause 32. In several provisions, penalties from 5 lakhs to 10 lakhs have been provided for. But sir, I think that this amount is very small amount. Nowadays, 5 lakh, 10 lakhs for a shipping company is nothing. It should be at least 25, 30 lakhs. That is my suggestion to the Honorable Minister. Sir, the next point is that in Clause 3, the national authority, this bill proposes to establish a national authority. And what will be the formation of national authority? It will comprise of an officer not below the rank of Joint Secretary. So only one officer will comprise the national authority. Why not any qualified environmentalist included in the national authority? I wonder. It will be a one-man show. So my request to the government will be, through you, sir, that this point should be taken care of, that one reputed environmentalist should be included in the authority, national authority. Sir, the next point is that in proviso to clause 8, subclause 1, the owner of a ship, if he has not applied, is to make application to national authority within 5 years from the commencement of the act. Why so long period has been given for application to the national authority? Why not 1 year? I think that 1 year is more than reasonable time. So the time period should be reduced. This is my suggestion, that it should not be 5 years, so long period. It must be restricted within 1 year. Sir, my next point, in clause 13, subclause 4, it is stated that competent authority may suspend or cancel any ship recycling facility without issuing any notice. This is, sir, highly arbitrary. And arbitrariness on the part of the governmental authorities is antithesis to rule of law. So there should not be such provision. There should be a provision for, although in some other provisions, there is a provision for giving notice, but here it says that any time it can cancel, suspend, whatever, without giving a notice. Giving opportunity of being heard is a necessity, condition precedent to natural justice. So I would request the government to consider this. Sir, now, sir, I would like to refer to a judgment. Some people have said about the Supreme Court judgment, even the Honorable Minister, who is otherwise a very competent minister, he has referred to the Honorable Supreme Court judgment. I would like to refer one judgment dated 11 September 2007 of Supreme Court in the matter of Research Foundation of Science versus Union of India and another, in writ petition number 657 of 1995, wherein the Apex Court mentioned about section 3.3.2 of the expert committee, I mean technical experts on ship breaking activities committee, dated 30th August 2006, and issued directions for strict compliance. There are so many guidelines that committee prescribed for performance of those guidelines, and Supreme Court ruled that those guidelines should be adhered to. So, but there is nothing, no murmur about those guidelines in this bill. So I request the government to incorporate those guidelines in the bills or the, in the rules or in the regulations. Sir, in this judgment, Supreme Court at para 11, I want to quote 1, 2, 3 lines with your kind permission. Quote, when we apply the principle of sustainable development, we need to keep in mind the concept of development on one hand and the concepts like generation of revenue, employment and public interest on the other. This is where the principle of proportionality comes in. And this concept of balancing is also given importance by Dr. Amartya Sen in his book Development as Freedom, unquote. So I have mentioned about Dr. Amartya Sen. Nobody should object to that, because nowadays this name is not very familiar, not very acceptable to many people. But Dr. Amartya Sen has also said this. Now, sir, my final point would be that this recycling of ships is not only hazardous for the environment, it also hazardous for particularly for those laborers who are working in this recycling process. And sufficient safeguards are to be taken for the interest of the laborers who work in this recycling of shipping process. Sir, unless the law, rules or guidelines are strictly followed in this regard, then, sir, it would create hell on earth. So I expect, sincerely hope and believe, that the Honourable Minister will accept the suggestions of the members who are deliberating on this issue today. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.